If you drive about 6 miles east of the town of Smyrna, Delaware, you will come to an amazing ecosystem called a tidal salt marsh. It is located right next to Delaware Bay, and it is the home to a large number of different plants and animals. In order to understand the tidal salt marsh, we need to take a short trip to Delaware Bay, where water from the Delaware River makes its way to the Atlantic Ocean. Here we see numerous streams that flow between the tidal salt marsh and the bay. Salty bay water flows up these streams and into the marsh with every high tide. As low tide approaches, water from the marsh flows back out into the bay. This important exchange of water and the nutrients and marine life it carries is the key to the great number of living things that thrive here. And it provides plenty of water for the plants that grow along the tidal streams. If you look across the tidal salt marsh in summertime, you will see a beautiful sea of densely packed grasses. And if you counted the number of plants growing on each acre of marshland, you would find that the tidal salt marsh is one of the most productive ecosystems on Earth. We've seen that the tidal salt marsh has a great supply of water. So how about sunlight? Look across the marsh, and you'll notice that very few trees live in this area, and there are few areas of shade. The marsh grasses receive plenty of direct sunlight, and they use the sun's energy to convert water and carbon dioxide into plant matter. This process is called photosynthesis, and plants are classified as producers because through photosynthesis, plants are able to produce their own food. With so many plants producing all this food, it's easy to see why the tidal salt marsh is a great habitat for animals that eat plants. Animals that eat plants are called primary consumers. At dawn and dusk, numerous white-tailed deer and cottontail rabbits come out to graze on the plants growing here. Many other types of animals live in the marsh and feed on the large supply of plants that grow here. Some of the smaller animals, such as certain insects, worms, shrimp, and fiddler crabs, get their nutrients by eating tiny particles of decomposed plant matter called detritus. Detritus is formed when the stems and leaves of marsh grasses die in the late fall or winter. They fall to the ground where bacteria cause them to decompose and to break down. The bacteria that break down plant matter into detritus are called decomposers. This process continues year after year, and it adds many nutrients to the soil in the marsh. This is important because the insects, crabs, shrimp, and worms that dine on detritus are a food source for larger animals, such as raccoons, fish, and birds. Animals that eat other animals are called secondary consumers. In the tidal salt marsh, herons and egrets stalk slowly along the streams, searching for fish to eat. Eagles, osprey, and hawks soar overhead, on the lookout for fish and other animals that would make a tasty meal. Raccoons eat both plants and animals, and they especially like to eat the fiddler crabs they find here. Besides providing food, the tidal salt marsh provides shelter for many species. Young fish and shellfish often start their lives within the shelter of the tidal streams. They can feed and grow here, where they are safe from the many large predators commonly found in the open water of the bay and ocean. Muskrats use marsh grasses to build their lodges. Otters dig their tunnels in the soft mud, and they feast on fish and shellfish that they find in the tidal streams. Swallows, wrens, and red-winged blackbirds build nests here. Ducks, geese, and other migratory birds stop to rest and feed in the marsh as they migrate with the changing of the seasons. On hot, sunny days, it's not unusual to see a snake slither by. Or you might catch a glimpse of a turtle or terrapin basking in the sunlight. Millions of fiddler crabs live in the tidal salt marsh. They dig short burrows into the mud where they find shelter from the weather and a place to hide from predators. If you take a few minutes to watch the fiddler crabs, you can see them picking up small pieces of detritus and putting it in their mouths. You may notice some tracks near the opening of the crab burrows. Signs left by hungry raccoons searching for a tasty meal of crab. Soft mud is a good place to look for tracks from other marsh animals, too. You might see the tracks of a fox that passed by looking for small rodents to eat, or tracks from a large wading bird that walked along the stream. You can see that the tidal salt marsh is a very special place. We say it's like a perfect farm because it has plenty of sun, water, and fertile soil, which means a lot of plants can grow here. And that means a lot of animals can find food, shelter, and nesting and resting places here.